green screen. Here, we talk about the matching of the character of the light with the virtual image. Here we will show the secret of matching the character of the light on our talent with the character of lighting in different virtual backgrounds. Usually, great care is taken to light the green floor and background evenly. When the talent is placed in this uniform green desert, it is now possible to key in any kind of magical background. The desert, the market square, the king's palace, even the landscape with the sunset. But usually, the lighting on the talent never matches the lighting of the virtual background. Very sad. Many of the older generation know about a book called Painting with Light. Still today, a valid book. My friend Bill Lee, who was taking care of lighting at Thames Television in England, turned the title around and called it Lighting with Paint. Now, he was trying to describe how he instructed his set painters to continue the lighting of the foreground set into the painted backdrop. I am now turning this around again, an attempt to show a perfect and easy solution how to match the lighting character on the talent with many different lighting situations in the virtual background. We use 5 of our focusing bicolor DLED7 lights, which have 2x90-watt LED light sources each, allowing to adjust color temperature between 2700 and 6500 Kelvin. We space out these lights evenly. For this very demonstration, we put the crossbar on lighting stands. Whilst in a real final version, of course, the lights will be hanging down from the studio grid. On the opposite side of the studio, we also put another 5 lights in a similar way. Each of these lights is fitted with my wide angle spreader, which changes the light distribution from normal flood function to a spread light distribution which can be oriented. In this case, we make sure that the orientation is all in the same axis. Each row of these 5 lights with my wide angle spreaders now provides a continuous and homogeneous river of light, which can be tuned continuously in intensity as well in color temperature. And thus far, such lighting methods have been deemed nearly impossible. Why? Shadows. On the one hand, even the most primitive keying software allows for gentle shadows, which in this case we're avoiding to a large extent by the continuity of our river of light. For this demonstration, we've also added one of our bicolor LED soft lights, a LED Raptor 5, a 500-watt bicolor soft light. Of course, other lighting effects from the front side can be chosen for individual tuning and eye light effects. Here's Bernhard, the owner of the studio. And for the virtual background, we've chosen an image of a forest with sunlight coming from the right rear side. Here we show a lighting version where our river of light is set to near daylight color temperature. Then we change for tungsten version to show a different character interpretation. Now here, the virtual image shows a landscape with the sunset. And here we show how our river of light from the rear left, set into near tungsten color temperature, imitates the effect of the sunset on the face. Sasha, standing near to the window, looks all right. But once we simulate the incoming daylight, it looks a lot more convincing. In this scene, we see that the continuous and homogeneous river of light function allows our talent to move and walk without any noticeable change of light intensity. Thus, we defy the rule of inverse square law, which in normal lighting seems to be difficult to do. This is just a very simple first introduction to this kind of a concept, without attempting to refine the individual images, only to show you that this possibility exists and can be applied easily.